AI inference for embedded applications, how to make them more scalable, how to make them perform better. I'm here with Christian Farber. He's the field application engineer at the Altera Corporation, and we're here at the Embedded World in Germany.
Great having me here.
Yeah, it's good to have you, Christian. So if we talk about AI inferencing, we see here some examples of inferencing, running algorithms. Can you explain what it exactly is, and can you give some examples?
Yes. For inference, we're talking about the processing of machine learning. So we are not talking about the training phase. And with FPGAs, we're talking about the embedded area. So embedding tightly integrated into a readout chain efficiently. And we help you if you think that you can augment, improve your outcome, your value of the data you get from your sensors with machine learning, and you would like to add these kind of algorithms to it. We help you to port your already trained models into the FPGA. And that's what we are doing with OpenVINO and AI Suite.
And can you give examples, for example, in healthcare or examples in manufacturing or in quality control?
Yeah, so for medical application, for example, image processing, this AI is a lot about image processing. We are talking, and this is for, for example, image processing for classification for tissue and other application, medical. And also there it's important to have low latency, live pictures directly analyzed in medicine. Mm-hmm. And also the same also for manufacturing lines in industry, for example, to find failures in products. And we can also port with very embedded and tightly integrated systems with FPGAs.
And we were talking about having them perform better. What's the difference between having an FPGA or no FPGA with performance?
The performance, what we have here on the FPGA, that we can tightly integrate it with a lower power it's using. And also from the performance, we are very performing against the other embedded microcontrollers. And this is something this flexibility of an FPGA, that's its value. Right? Why everyone who is using FPGA is using it because of its flexibility and adaptability to his custom solution he's implementing for his customers.
And in the flexibility, you're talking then about updating the algorithm?
For example, and also the flexibility of what kind. We are not supporting only a single network and multiple numbers of networks, and we also can scale them to the performance you need. You need some lower performance inference already for your application. We can do it very efficiently in a corner. We can also add multiple of these inference engines on the device. We can also conjugate them together to stream them together into another models afterwards. And also we can send to high performance. We have there up to 56 tops in our new Agilex 5 FPGA you can reach. Also because of these improved DSP blocks we have there, which are augmented with AI inference capacity.
And as we talk about inference at the edge, latency is important as well.
Correct, yes.
So how does the FPGA improve that?
This, because you directly in the FPGA connect your sensor directly to your inference engine, and also add inference, you can make a readout pipe. And inside this readout pipe, you have also the pre-processing integrated, your inference engine, and then also your post-processing of your data, which make it very low latency, also for security issues with predictable latency.
And what would be your tip for everybody who is running inference at the edge?
Yeah, they will hopefully use FPGAs.
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Christian. Thank you for the audience from here, from the embedded world. Thank you for watching, and we're looking forward to seeing you next time.